Get ready to match the stars from Trapper John, Charles Siebert, Brett Summer, Charles Nelson Reilly. From Vegas, Phyllis Davis. From Mork and Mindy, Robert Donner. And Marcia Wallace. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now here's the star of Match Game, Gene Rayburn.
Shall we? Are you ready?
Yes, I am.
What would you like to do?
I would like to play the game, the audience poll.
Oh, all right. Well, then you have to step around down here and join me on the stage here and take your little place on the blue dot, and we'll have a go at it here. Because you won the game, Connie, and you're going to have a go at the really big money now. This is the first game you played, right?
Yes.
All right. Let's see how you do. We polled the studio audience. As we said, write down your best answer to this. Turn off the blank. Remember, $500 for matching the most.
Turn off the blank.
Should have worn your specs.
Not turn off.
Turn of the
turn
blank.
Off the.
She says, turn of the back, and right there it is. Okay.
How?
What's that? Now wait a minute. Now, one thing you have to understand: it don't do no good to talk unless I hold a mic in front of your mouth. You see. So when I hold it in front of your mouth, then you can start talking.
How about Marcia?
Oh, gosh. I think Brett was born around the turn of the century.
I'm going to get you. I'm going to get you. Now you're going to be a sorry woman for that.
Oh, that's one.
Remember that we room together.
Who else?
Okay, Brett, I'll give you your chance now.
Well, I couldn't say this about Marcia, but... Turn of the screw.
What? It's a famous play.
Charles, can you do better than that?
Henry James wrote Turn of the Screw, my dear. Oh,
that's right.
Get with the newer things, I told you. Okay, a very moving, poignant one.
Turn of the tables.
Not that poignant. Turn of the road.
Turn of the Road?
That song by Roger Miller.
Turn of the Road.
Turn of the Road.
So you have Turn of the Road, Turn of the Screw, and Turn of the Century. Do you want one of those or one of your own?
I'll go with Marcia's Turn of the Century.
All right. Turn of the Century. Let's see if it's under the $100 response. Turn of the Dial. Right. I hear him clicking all over the country now, even as we're on the air this moment there. May we see the next one, please? Turn of the Screw.
See,
there's Henry
fun.
James.
You've got to go get educated, kid.
All right. Last chance. Here we go. Yeah. You got it. Now, Connie, you've got the $500. That means at least you'll play for us 10 times that amount, or $5,000. However, remember, you will spin the wheel, and if you get lucky, you will play for $10,000. Step right up here, and can you reach that peg right there? Give it a spin, and away you go.
On
bent.
The cusp.
Yeah, you were on the cusp. That's right, Robert. You bent the...
Oh, that's Robert.
Oh, that Robert. Oh, there's Robert down there. Bob, as we like to call him.
Yes.
Okay, step right down here, if you would, please.
Okay.
And here we go.
No, no, I'm her. You sit here.
Robert, she's a parson's wife. Be careful.
No, a twist.
Are you ready?
Yes, I am, sir.
Okay, Bob, here we go. Good luck. Blank paints. P-A-I-N-T-S. Blank paints. Now, if you give us the answer that he has on the card, we give you $5,000. What do you say to that?
Well, I'm not sure about this, but knowing Robert, I would say finger paints.
Why would you say a thing like that about Robert?
Well, I was going to say oil paints, but he's just a little different. In the best sense of the
never met this girl before in my life.
She says you're a flake.
She's right.
Just because a man makes a living in a dress and boots doesn't mean he's strange.
Right.
Could have been oil paints, could have been water. There's a lot of answers it could have been. Finger.
$5,500. Congratulations to you. Now let's bring back Elsley Colbert.
Well, isn't she excited? All right, Connie, you can climb back up there on the bandwagon. Yeah. She's very excited. We'll give her a chance to compose herself, Elsley, and you can tell this audience again about you, where you're from, and all that sort of thing.
I'm Elsley Colbert, or Colbert, whatever. And I'm a original.
Now, wait a minute. You don't know how to pronounce your name? You say Colbert or Colbert?
Well, in Florida, it's Colbert. In Hollywood, it's Colbert, you know.
Colbert. Well, the place is full of flakes,
Florida,
right?
Florida is my sister.
I love her laugh.
I'm originally from West Palm Beach, Florida. And I work for the L.A. Unified School District.
L.A. Unified School District.
Yes, and I love to sing and tell nasty jokes.
All right. While you are watching this commercial, she is going to talk to me. Buddy, would you get the pep-up pills, please? I mean, we can't have these dead contestants lying around like this. Elsley, you ready to play?
Yes, I think so.
What would you like?
I think I'll take B.
B? B is the funniest letter in the alphabet.
It's hilarious.
After K.
What is she so depressed about?
I don't know.
What's your problem, Elsley?
Here it is, Elsley. Judy said, I'll never go back to that rotten dentist. Hey, that idiot, he tried to use a blank to clean my teeth. Tried to use a blank to clean my teeth. Now we're ready, Elsley. Judy said, I'll never go back to that rotten dentist. That idiot, he tried to use a blank to clean my teeth.
A Brillo soap pad.
A Brillo soap pad. Good. Very good. She laughs good and she gives good answers.
Some dentist you got out of West Palm Beach. A broom.
A broom. Yeah. That would hurt. Hey, wait a minute. Yeah.
The little darling is obviously too smart for the room. I said dust rag.
Dust rag. Brillo is excellent.
I'll blow it out your ear. You heard me.
I said cold water all.
Cold water all. So far, no Brillo over here, or steel wool, or anything like that.
No, I said electric sander.
Electric sander, that would be painful and stupid of the dentist, too, wouldn't it? What'd you say, Bob?
I don't think they're going to like this one. Whisk broom.
Whisk broom. Right.
They're turning.
Now, Bob, you sit down there. You're a major TV star. You get up here and sit down. Don't let them people intimidate you.
Right.
You tell them, fat lady.
That's right.
I do.
You proved me before I even started. Okay, get ready. Mop.
They liked yours, but they didn't like theirs there. Connie, you ready?
I should ready. Be over there.
Nancy said, I just read a revised version of a fairy tale, and it's really revised. Instead of yelling, Rapunzel, Rapunzel, let down your hair, the prince yelled, Rapunzel, Rapunzel, let down your blank.
Fairy tale helps.
Go ahead, read it aloud.
Nancy said, I just read a revised version of a fairy tale. It's really revised. Instead of yelling, "Rapunzel, Rapunzel, let down your hair," the prince yelled, "Rapunzel, Rapunzel, let down your blank."
See, now I fill in the blank.
Right. Right. This is very difficult. I would say your rope ladder.
Oh, they'll turn on you.
What was your first thought?
I thought of escape hatch.
Oh, they like right. The second one.
What do you got there, Charles?
What could they possibly have against rope ladders? I can't take credit for this. Brett gave me this. Drawers.
Drawers!
Rapunzel, Rapunzel, let down your suppos.
I said your Clair Oil, son of a gun hairdryer.
Clair Oil, son of a gun hairdryer. Why did you?
Thank you.
Give it to him.
That's the brand name, son of a gun. It's like a gun. I use it myself.
All right. Rapunzel, Rapunzel, let down your...
clothes.
Your clothes. It's okay. What'd you say, Bob?
I won't go to filth. Moral code.
Let down your moral code. What'd you say?
It's embarrassing to sit right next to him, a man of his principle. Because I went right for it.
You did.
Panties.
All right. Did you think of that?
Well, is it?
You didn't think of that?
No comment.
No comment. All right. Now, let's see. Since we have a tie score and she went first last time, you go first this time.
I'll choose A.
All right, Connie. Jackie the comic said, "My wife is a real jerk. Today she held a garage sale and sold a blank." Brum chop. Jackie the comic said, "My wife is a real jerk. Today she held a garage sale and sold a blank."
I have 6 chances. The garage.
Yeah! All right. What do you say, Charlie boy?
Garage?
Garage.
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 Okay, Connie, we're now traveling on the same road to stardom. Garage.
Okay.
Car.
The car. Had a garage sale and sold a car. Car is an excellent answer. Do not boo car. Otherwise, Johnny Olson single-handedly will eject you forcibly. Yes.
Yeah.
Car. Yeah.
That goes triple for me, gang.
All right. That's 3 cars. What do you say?
Doo-dah, doo-dah. Garage.
Garage. Cars and 3 garages. Alza Lee, you need 3 to tie and 4 to win. Mean Marvin is so mean.
How mean is he?
Instead of a cage, he keeps his pet bird in a blank. Ready?
Yeah.
Well, don't stare in space that way. Mean Marvin is so mean, instead of a cage, he keeps his pet bird in a...
In a dog house.
I don't... Well, the bird wouldn't be too uncomfortable there. We were thinking of some place where the bird would not be very happy.
Yes, but it's still difficult. I said in an oven.
In an oven.
Oh.
He'd be unhappy there. That's all right. An oven or a...
Now, listen, I've got a bone to pick with you.
What?
I've been staring into space for 7 years, and suddenly you turn on me and tell me not to stare into space.
All of a sudden, you don't like it.
All of a sudden, it's over between us.
Everybody is finished, and you're standing there with your card poised.
I know. That's what I mean. I've been doing that for 7 years.
It's not out of the slot.
I've been doing that for 7 years.
And then we're ready to go. Yes.
All of a sudden, it's over. No, I hate that question.
Me too.
Everybody hates this question.
Hey, Ira.
We should take that question back and get this woman a decent question. Swimming pool.
That would be bad for the bird.
Betty
because it
White
would drown.
Would really hate that because it would drown the
right.
Devil.
A cat house.
Whoa. Keeps the bird in a cat house. Mean Marvin is so mean, instead of a cage, he keeps his pet bird in a blank. And she's a doghouse, but anything like a drawer, a chest of drawers, or anything where the bird would be unhappy, it'd be all right. What have you got?
How about a box?
In a box, that's okay, but that means Connie Carmody wins the game. What do you have there, Bob?
In a kitty little box.
Kitty little box in the freezer. All right, come on down, Connie. Have another go at the big money. Well, you'll be going now.
Thank you. Nice seeing you.
Nice to see you. It was a pleasure to meet you and to have you here, and I hope they send you a lot of nice gifts from the Mets game. Goodbye.
Bye.
That was your little business with America. Here you are.
If you'd like to come to the studio and see Match Game in person, write to us. Enclose a self-addressed stamped envelope and mail the tickets. Match Game, CBS Television City, 7800 Beverly Boulevard, Los Angeles, California, 90036.
Now, Connie here is very happy because she has already won $5,500. What plans do you have for that loot?
None yet. I wouldn't let myself think about what I would do.
You can buy your goat, hon.
My horses.
You can buy your goat and your horse.
Oh,
you can buy a whole bunch of horses.
I'll have to check with my
husband. And a telephone. Don't forget a telephone.
Yes, he is. He's right.
Is it all right if she buys a horse? Where is he?
Maybe.
You're a parson, for heaven's sake.
All right, you don't get none of the money if she can't buy a horse. She was going to throw in a little for you, but now it's all off. Listen.
That's the way it works in our house.
No, it's not, I see.
No.
All right, here we go. We polled the studio audience, and we said, write down your best answer to this. The blank wolf. Remember, you get $500 for matching the most popular, $250 for the second most popular, and $100 for the third. Whom do you want?
How about Charles?
The big bad wolf.
There's one.
I'll have to ask Robert, too, since he was so good to me the last time.
Yes, and you remember that. Let her buy what she wants.
That's right.
The lone wolf.
The lone wolf. Okay, Bob.
And how about Charlie?
The sea.
Very good.
Oh, excellent.
The sea wolf. All right. They have the sea wolf. They don't know. See, they don't know.
John
the sea wolf.
Garfield.
No,
Richie
no.
Robinson.
Jack London.
Right. Jack London wrote it. John Garfield was in it there. All right, the sea wolf, the big bad wolf, and the lone wolf. Those are the three you've got. You may choose one of those or think up one of your own.
I think I'm partial to children's stories, so the big bad wolf.
Yay!
Let's find out if we have the big bad wolf up there, and if so, where? Let's take a look at the $100 response. The boy who cried wolf. That was another children's story.
Him.
Yes. All right, let's take a look at the next one, please. The werewolf. And nothing there that they gave you. That surprises me, because I thought their answers were pretty good. All right, we're looking for the big bad wolf. Let's see if we've got it under the big number. Yeah. Very good. Connie, you now have another $500 that gives you
She's
in cash.
Kissing everyone in Hollywood, Barbara. All over the place, Reverend.
Now, you have a total of cash in hand here of $6,000, and you can play for another $5,000 right now and end up with a total of $11,000 if you get another.
Good. Good luck.
But you
good
could
luck.
No, you
good
could
luck.
End up with a lot more than that. You could
Just
end up with $15,000.
You can get a whole
$16,000. Just slid by that star. All right, you are playing for $5,000 with Phyllis Davis. Are you ready, my dear?
Mm-hmm.
All right, face me, and this is it. Blank vegetable. Blank vegetable. Now, Phyllis has given her answer and put it on the card in the slot. If you give us the same one, if you match her, you get another $5,000. What do you say?
think it would be a miracle if they matched. I'll say fresh vegetable.
Oh, wow. Well, that would be two in a row for her if she got that. She won the $5,000 last time. That means she'd win another $5,000, end up with $11,000. Wouldn't that be a miracle?
It sure would.
It sure would.
Because I put fresh vegetables. Uh-huh.
Church of Miracles, which will be built right here.
We're laying the foundation for the Reverend's new church out there. Thank you, Charles. And now we've got this message for you. A lot of excitement here. Thank you, one and all. You were wonderful. Boy, Gene Rayburn, join us next time for the match game. Goodbye.
Today's consolation prizes are a 7-piece Performer Gourmet Cutlery Set with extra sharp chrome stainless steel blades and Ebony Fleetwood handles. Just wash and save for washing and pouring. An Amcor Freshen Air Electronic Air Ionizer and smoke, odors, dust, pollen, bacteria in your automobile. Freshen air for fresher air everywhere. And a walk in La Choy Chinese Food. Let your meal swing American with La Choy bean sprouts, vegetables, water chestnuts, bamboo shoots, and soy sauce. And a Betty Crocker cookbook can make someone happy with new improved Super Moist. Now even better than before, other cakes may be moist, but they're not super moist. And a honey dish and pure sous vide honey. No synthetic or artificial ingredients. You haven't tried honey till you try the natural goodness of sous vide honey. And a baby bath and changing pad plus Diaperine baby washcloth. Moisture-packed towels for lanolin to clean and condition. Keep your baby better than clean with Diaperine. And a pen and pencil set and liver snaps. Treats for dogs, the real liver. No wonder dogs really love them. Liver snaps. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. This program is edited for broadcast.